From the moment you see them, in full flight, it takes your breath away. Excited voices calling to each other. In Bhutan, the black-necked cranes are revered as reincarnates of long-gone ancestors. In a nation of Buddhists, nature and the cranes are sacred. The country folk are in touch with the earth and the rhythms of the seasons. Parents teach their children that conservation comes first. They call their country Drukyul, the land of the thunder dragon, and they take pride in their cultural traditions and take aim with their hearts at happiness and friendship. It's a peaceful kingdom with a reverent vision, skillfully shaped from wood and stone. In fortress monasteries called dzongs, built in the 17th century, doorways open. The prayer wheel spins its inspiration. The past and future come face to face. The fifth king is deeply rooted in Bhutan's cultural traditions. Guided by the principles of gross national happiness, Bhutan marches to the beat of its own drum. Never dispossessed from their land by colonialism, and never divided from their spiritual traditions, Bhutan's collective memory of itself is deep and unbroken. In a world of vanishing cultures, its richness in memories is precious and rare. Here at the entrance to the monastery, poised atop ancient wooden pillars, are these elegant carvings of black-necked cranes. The cranes resonate deeply in the hearts of the local people. The legends say that when the wintering black-necked cranes arrive, they circle the monastery three times, and they repeat this circling ritual in the springtime when they return to Tibet.